Well, thank you. And that was made by our film students, led by Ufuk, who's here today. Give you an idea of what we do when we're not doing a festival. Hey, Raindance is different. Raindance is very different. You know, we have the Oscars and we have the BAFTAs, and they crave visibility through being this sort of vanilla neutrality. And also, and fashion, just cheap fashion. Raindance is different. Raindance is a collection of people, our filmmakers, our jury, our audience, the staff that put all this amazing festival together. And what we all share in common is that we have a voice and we believe stuff. And that's why we're here today. One of the people that has joined the team a year and a half ago is someone that has really changed the whole future of Raindance and some exciting plans that you will be seeing in the days and weeks ahead. His name is Byron Rose. He's our new chairman of Raindance. I want to hear lots of applause for Byron Rose.
Good morning, everybody. Thank you so much for coming. I just want to say I'm going to be very brief today, but there are many people in the room today who are independent filmmakers, and it is one of the hardest things in life to do. You have to be so passionate. You have to have tenacity. You have to be a trailblazer, a maverick, and generally, you're an underdog. So we celebrate all of you incredible people who have pushed to tell stories and to get it out there. And no matter what happens today, everyone, and everyone always says this, everyone's always a winner, but it is true. Actually, we absolutely salute everybody who has been put up for a potential Raindance Award. The second point I want to say is that we are reloading Raindance going forward. Raindance is a very, very important institution because we want to support all independent filmmakers in your journey and your mission going forward. And we need help. We need support and help from anybody within the film industry that is willing to come and give your time, give your support, give your ideas, whatever it may be, to be able to push this amazing institution forward. And I just want to say, somebody who doesn't actually get recognition or praise and gets a lot of stick is actually the founder of Raindance, Elliot Grove, who set it up 30 years ago and has been pushing to support the underdog ever since. So let's just give a hand to Elliot. I also want to thank the programmers who have done an exceptionally hard task of putting on a festival, because we changed the time from winter to summer and only had 7 months to put on a festival. So they have done an incredible job. Can you stand up, both of you, please? Where are you, girls? Amazing. Thank you so much. And also, everyone behind the scenes, every single person within Raindance, you've done incredible things. So with that, let us commence with the exciting part of awards. Over to you, Elliot.
We had the most amazing jury this year. We have assigned the jury? We do. Oh, it's there. Cool. Let me read these names out. Jared Harris, Diego Luna, Al Moro, Alice Englert, Klaus Bang, Daniel Green, Denise Parkinson, Emily's Ramjas, Ivana McKinnon, Jack Howard, Adam Morse, Joanne Michael, John McCrae, Katie Bignall, Nafi Gordon-Sai, Nathan Stewart Jarrett, and Paul Singh. How about a big round of applause for our jury? They were watching like 10 feature films each on the feature films, and God knows how many short films, their eyeballs have bled, but they've kept them open with toothpicks, we think. And we'll find out soon what they had. Now, the next thing we're going to talk about briefly here today is the Icon Award, which every year we've given to someone that we think deserves recognition, people that have impressed us at Raindance and our community of their outstanding achievement against the odds. Opening night ceremony a few days ago at the Mayfair, Curzon Mayfair, it was Chiwi Ejiofor who received the Icon Award. But today we have someone, and their list of credits is so lengthy, I should probably sit on a chair and so my legs don't get sore. And it's my absolute pleasure, really is, to present the 2024 Raindance Icon Award to someone who's directed not one, but three films that were nominated at the Palme d'Or. Can you imagine? And seven films, again, not one or two, but seven, that were nominated for the Golden Bear at Berlin, and one that was nominated for the Golden Lion at Venice. And get this, 18 of his films had have their North American premiere at the highly prestigious TIFF in Toronto or at Sundance. This isn't anyone, this is someone with an amazing career, but there's more, just wait, please be patient. He won the Francois Chalet Award at the Cannes Film Festival for A Mighty Heart, starring Angelina Jolie, and was nominated for the Palme d'Or for Welcome to Sarajevo. I'm giving you some hints now of who this person might be. In This World won the Golden Bear at Berlin and a BAFTA for Best Film in a Foreign Language. The Road to Guantanamo was won a Silver Bear at Berlin for Best Directing and a BIFFA for Best Documentary Film. BIFFA is part of the Raindance family. We started BIFFA all those years ago. Wonderland screened at Raindance way back in the late 90s and won a BIFFA for Best Film. Genova won a Silver Shell for Best Directing at San Sebastian. He's been a humanities visiting professor in film and television in Oxford University. He is an honorary fellow at Balliol College in Oxford and is an honorary director of letters at Bristol University. His name is Michael Winterbottom. Michael, hope you get it. The three R's of Raindance, you start your film idea, it's kind of rusty, you get it a bit polished, mm-hmm. and at some point, ta-da, bright and shiny,
you hope.
The story of the award.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you very much, and thank you for... Thanks very much, and thank you for the kind introduction. And I want to say I'm incredibly happy to get this award. Especially from Raindance, which has been promoting independent cinema here in the UK for as long as I've been making films. So I'm really proud to get it from this festival. But what I just want to say something very quickly is congratulations, first of all, to all the people who are going to win prizes today. I think most of you are first-time or second-time filmmakers, and we all know how incredibly hard it is to get a film made, let alone to get it shown at Raindance and then win a prize. So congratulations. But I remember the first thing I directed was about a documentary about Ingmar Bergman, and he'd made more than 50 feature films, and making films was his part-time job. His main job was running a theatre company in Stockholm, the Dramaten, the main theatre company. And if you think back about all the great filmmakers in the sort of post-war era in Europe, people like Godard and Truffaut were making a film a year all through the 60s and 70s, more than 30 films in total. People like Fellini and Rossellini were the same. Someone like Fassbinder made more than 40 films when he stopped making because he died at the age of 37. And then a few years ago, during COVID lockdown, I interviewed 15 of my favorite independent British film directors for a book for the BFI. I'd say two-thirds of them have made less than a handful of films here in the UK, less than a handful of independent films. They'd all started in independent cinema, they'd all had great success. they made less than a handful of British independent films. So I think, you know, I kind of think it's great what Raindance is doing, but I would say to Raindance, to Byron, to Elliot, to all the people involved in film culture, it'd be great to think that all the people who are winning their prizes here today, in 30 years' time, will be able to look back, like people that, like Godard and Truffaut did, and look back on a career of making a film a year or a film every 2 years. Filmmaking is no more complicated today than it was then, but something in the culture has changed, and now it's expected that you might make one film or two films, maybe a film every 4 or 5 years after that. It'd be great to go back to the culture of filmmakers who put all that effort and time in to get their first film made, are then supported and nurtured through the whole of their career, so they can look back on a lifetime of making films, and we can all watch those films. So good luck to you all. Thank you.
Emotional. Thank you, Michael. That means a lot. Your speech really hit a nerve. Thank you. I'll remember that. I think we all will. Next, I'm going to present the award for the best unproduced screenplay. And there's an envelope somewhere because I have no idea who it is. Oh, it's right here. Yay. Under the table. Best unproduced screenplay. Drum roll on all that stuff. It goes to... The winner for Best Unproduced Screenplay is Daryl Wimberly.
Thank you. First of all, following the last gentleman, I really feel diminutive, so I want to thank you for all the people being here and for all the support. One of the most frustrating things for anyone writing here, and there are a lot of good writers here, are just getting the screenplay read. Of course there are pitches, of course there are pitch decks, all number of stories about helping get films made. But I did my film, my screenplay, based on a novel that I'd written that won an award for women's historic fiction. So it started more than 10 years ago. And between the novel and the research to do that and then writing a screenplay later, I've been represented at William Morris and other places, but I've never had a community that was so serious about reading the script. And I cannot tell you how grateful I am to the readers here and to Raindance for actually reading the script. And I hope if you're a filmmaker here, a producer, a director, they're within a rock's throw of where you're sitting. There are a dozen good scripts, so take time to read them. Thank you so much.
Please welcome our next presenters, Nafi Gordon-Sai, head of home entertainment at Dogwoof, and Ashanti Amkar, broadcaster and film critic.
I'm not Ashanti, just in case you're asking, she couldn't make it, so sorry about that.
Well, let's move on to the shorts, and congratulations to everyone who made the shortlist. So, first, we're going to look at the Best Documentary Short Award.
My mind goes back to you.
Made the terrible mistake of losing my life savings.
It starts in the future, like sometime in the future.
When
Now I have the great honor of presenting the Best Documentary Short winner to A Body Called Life.
Hello, everyone. I don't know what to say. This is the biggest award I've ever gotten. This is the most I've ever worked on a project, so to get recognition like this is makes me very touched. I'm also very nervous being up here. So I want to say thank you to Raindance for the amazing programming and for selecting our film. All of the shorts I saw were just at such a high caliber, so I'm honored that we had our film amongst those films. To our protagonist who opened up his whole life and his vulnerability for us to make a story in an unconventional way. To our producer, Pascal, and the rest of our team, production companies, and everybody just did so much. And yeah, thank you. Thank you, everybody.
Much easier. And the next award we're going to present is the Best Animated Short, and have a look at our lovely nominees.
I am stopped. My heart aches. Compassion. Unsolicited. And I know.
Encontraram-se pela primeira vez quando a rapariga de olhos grandes era ainda muito nova e o rapaz de pernas compridas não tão novo.
And the winner for Best Animated Short is 74. Sadly, they are not here with us tonight, but we have a video.
Hello, Raindance. I am Haralambos Margaritis. I am the director of 74, and I would like to thank all the members of the jury for honoring my film with this great distinction. I really wish I could have been there with you today, but unfortunately I had to be back to Cyprus for work. I wish a great rest of the festival to all of you, and I really hope to get the chance to see you again very soon. Bye-bye. Thank you again.
And now on to our next category, Best Live Action Short.
Hey. Oh, it's good. Chin up a little bit. Down, cut the difference. Yeah, I love that.
As good as any. This place is as good as any. This place is as good as any.
疎外感, 後ろめたさ, 憐憫, そういった感情が行き場を失った結果渦となって良くないものを呼び込む。
And the winner for the best live action short is The Masterpiece. We have a quick video from the directors.
Hi there. I am Alex Lora, and I am the director of The Masterpiece. I know that it's not a very humble title for a short film. I promise that in Spanish doesn't sound as arrogant. But anyways, I'm very happy that the jury consider that we deserve this award, even if the short film is not masterpiece. And at the same time, I'm kind of sad because until the last moment, I thought that I could make it on person. But my boss didn't allow me to leave the editing room, so I cannot go. I want to thank all the festival organizers, programming team, of course, the jury, thank you so much, and the audiences. And I would like to share it with all the filmmakers that, you know, are hanging out there. I think that being selected in Raindance, it's already a great accomplishment, and it's something to feel very happy and proud about. And I would like to dedicate it to my daughter. She lives in London, and I would love that, you know, that she gets to see this. Thank you so much, guys. Hopefully we'll be there in the future with a new short films, or, you know, with a real masterpiece, who knows. Thank you so much.
And last but not least of the short categories, we have Best UK Short. So let's have a look at the films.
It is a breakthrough for all of you here. With your heads bowed and your hands.
I have a house.
You have a house.
Oh, you must be our new neighbour.
Yeah, hi.
We weren't over keen on the last tenant, were we, John Boy?
She didn't talk to me. It's not your fault.
Bless me, Father, for I have sinned.
The winner for the BAFTA qualifying Best UK Short is Housewarming.
Wow, I'm a bit gobsmacked, actually. Thank you. It's a miracle to get short films made. You can't have to will them into existence. And I couldn't have done it genuinely without loads of support from family, friends, just kind strangers. And, yeah, amazing. Thank you, Raindance, as well. Nice one. Cheers.
Now let's please welcome back on stage Byron Rose and one of our jury members, Denise Parkinson.
I'm going to do a
Philip thing. Oh, yeah.
Right. Hey, I want to get personal for a minute. It's not in the schedule here. I'm Canadian from Toronto. I went to art school, 3-year post-secondary degree, proclaims me an expert in absolutely nothing I do now. I am a qualified practitioner of something called cire perdue, lost wax bronze casting, the ancient art of the Greeks. And in my last year, I chose to study Picasso to write my thesis. And while writing that, Picasso died. And then there was an interview with a woman from New York called Gertrude Stein. And she was asked how the relationship between her and Picasso worked, because everything he sold through Gertrude Stein. And she was the one that found him in this horrible little garret in Paris when he had not enough money for food. And she made his career. To this very complicated question, she said a few words. She said, every vine needs a wall to grow on. And we have a picture here of the wall of Rain Dance. Philip Gambrill is someone I met 18 years ago when Rain Dance was struggling. Philip was the guy who I could call any time of night or day, any day of the week, and ask any question about banking or VAT or PAYE or what I should beware of in this transaction or that transaction. I last heard from him Tuesday night last week, right before the opening night, making sure that he and his wife Maxine had tickets for opening night, and he didn't show up. Of course, it was so busy. I sent him a mail, SMS the next day, how are you, bit of news. He normally is the kind of guy who respond to my messages in a couple of minutes. I didn't hear anything, and again the next day, and then at 5:15 on Friday, last Friday, Maxine, using her son's phone, Nathan, who's here today, who was an intern at Rain Dance, and I said, Nathan, she said, no, it's Maxine. I said, what's wrong? She said, Philip has passed Tuesday night. If any of you have ever lost anyone, you'll know how I felt this week. He was someone who was the steadying hand. And this picture, Nathan sent it to me last night. I Googled for a whole day. He was so modest. Not a single picture of him on the internet. He was the quiet guy. He was the one that supported everything we did. He's the one that made sure the whole team got their paychecks. He was our wall, and without him, Rain Dance would be a tangled heap of vines on the ground. Love you, dearest Philip. Miss you like mad. And Nathan, thanks for coming.
Thank you, Elliot. Very, very moving. I would like to, before we give this award, just briefly invite someone up just with us. David Martinez, where are you, please? Is he here? Has he gone out for a coffee? Okay, he's not here. He's coming. Okay. Sorry, I just sprung this on him. David runs the festival, pulls the festival together, is responsible for everyone. Here he comes. David, can you come here just briefly? Between Denise and I, we are huge fans of David, and he rarely gets sung. So I just want to, in the spirit of Rain Dance, we're just about to give this award. David is essential for what we do and has put on an incredible festival. So thank you, David. You can stay with us for this as well. So the Spirit of Rain Dance Award is a new award that's being given and is coming directly from Elliot and the jurors who have been selected very carefully to give it. It represents films that are extraordinary in the story that they tell, and all of the films within this category
were incredible, and it was incredibly difficult for the jury to decide, as Denise will vouch.
We took dogs and domesticated them. Humans did.
He's killing dogs here.
And we cannot betray their love, their trust, their loyalty.
This.
We could still be together.
I can't believe this, Peter. On my wedding night?
Guys, I know that, yeah, times are grim and rumors are swirling, but this administration would never fabricate enlistment numbers just to gerrymander, trust me.
I'm very blessed to have these two ladies come into my life.
I'm leaving some good friends.
Don't forget
us. It's wonderful to be able to be innocent and vulnerable and say whatever you wish to say.
Stripping worth it?
Is sexting legal? Is monogamy possible?
Guys act like it's so impossible.
I wanted to post this and I'd appreciate feedback.
You're thinking about something, I can tell.
He doesn't deserve you.
Get out of the cage.
Do you want to say a few words before we open up, Denise? Yeah.
Thank you, Byron, and echoing what you said, David, amazing. And Elliot and the Rain Dance family, I'm so sorry for your loss. No words. And Elliot, thank you so much for everything that you do for us. So emotional, but you give so many people so many opportunities. And Suzanne, amazing work that you guys have built over the years. So thank you. Can we just have a round of applause for Suzanne and Elliot? Thank you. And now I would like to announce, or we would like to announce, the Spirit of Raindance Award.
So the award goes to, Denise, you do the honors.
Oh my God, I voted for this, Dog War.
Amazing, well done.
All right, I'm supposed to say a few words, and I think that's okay. Yeah, the words aren't coming easily. This is I'm incredibly appreciative of this award and what it represents, and I thank the jurors for the difficult task of actually picking this film. It was a very challenging project. My films tend to be. The subjects tend to be difficult, focusing on suffering, and I don't think that anyone. I didn't think that this would be as challenging for people. A film about the dog meat trade in South Korea. But mostly, we want to close our eyes to suffering, and especially when it comes to animals and our best friends. So I'm just incredibly in awe and appreciative of this of pulling Dog War out of the many other deserving films, and it really is a testament for the boots on the ground work of my very small filmmaking team, and also of the activists in Korea and everywhere that are trying to put a stop to the dog meat trade, which happened, by the way, in 2027. It will begin in South Korea, and I hope in other places as well. So thank you, everybody. Thank you so, so much.
Gosh.
God, it's getting more emotional. The awards ceremonies are just not supposed to be emotional, are they? I'm pleased to introduce our next presenter and rising star, John McRae, from the West End musical hit Everybody's Been Talking About Jamie, for which he was Olivier nominated. John also starred in last year's debut feature, Femme, and in Disney's live-action film, Cruella, in 2021. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome John McRae.
Hello. I'm here to do Best Documentary Feature. Thanks for asking me to be on the jury. I really enjoyed it. It was a diverse and unique list of films, each one showcasing a special gift for informative storytelling, proving that once again, documentary making is not just educational and entertaining, but documentaries can, at their heart, with the help of a willing audience, they can truly change the world. So here are the nominees.
There were things that scared me and a lot of stuff I didn't want to hear. I wasn't prepared to hear.
You've got the Scots who are very reticent and quiet and shy. And you've got Scots when you get a drink in them at a ceilidh, just wild revelers.
Africa has been responsible for less than 4% of the emissions, but it is by far the most vulnerable region to the effects of climate change.
Case non finite. Gli stessi operai che lavorano di giorno in fabbrica e nel tempo libero in campagna hanno un sogno in comune.
Google, Meta, the parent company of Facebook and Instagram, these are basically advertising companies. The vast majority of their revenue comes from advertising.
A rather grotesque program.
When he goes crazy, it's sure to be on TV.
Tous les numéros que j'ai, en fait, tous les numéros sont faux.
Et là, j'ai découvert une vingtaine de messages avec plusieurs femmes.
And the winner for Best Documentary Feature is Searching for Amani.
Thank you so much, Rain Dance and the jury, for this award. I had the fine challenge of trying to find an outfit that's award appropriate and then airport appropriate as well. but thank you so much to Elliot and the team, David, Martina, Malaika. Those are the few that I've had the opportunity to interact with. Thank you for supporting independent film. Thank you for making us feel heard and seen and appreciated outside of our very own country. So you are supporting independent film not only in the UK, but all over the world, and you're giving us hope because we are just starting out. The industry is kind of messed up and we're just finally breaking through. So we do need festivals like yours, and I will be happy to support in whatever I can. And I hope that the audience here and the people who've been able to watch these amazing films will continue to support that. And I would like to dedicate this award to, if you've watched the film, one of the main characters, Haron's dad, passed away, unfortunately, on Saturday. And Simon and the rest of the family are with them there. So I would like to dedicate this award not only to Simon and my co-director, Nicole, who couldn't be here, but his father, Stephen Ali Apetet, and Lenkes Mariri, who is Haron's dad, who is not here with us, but got the opportunity to see his son excel beyond anything that he could imagine and travel farther than he could imagine. And that is in part thanks to the team, but thanks to also festivals like yours for giving us a platform. Thank you so much.
Please welcome to the podium Ivana McKinnon and Daniel Green.
Okay, so yeah, just on behalf of myself, Ivana and Jared, who can't sadly be here today, we're delighted to present the Raindance Award for Best International Feature, a really strong year. Yeah, let's take a look at the nominees.
You know the drill, y'all know how it goes down. You need to find the duckies, you need to find the bucket with the duckies on the count of three. One, two, three, hit it!
We need to define what we have built. Carve your adductus.
Why did you bring us here?
Your family belongs here.
That's a fucking weird way to put it. Tu fouilles ma chambre maintenant.
Ne change pas de sujet, réponds à ma question.
Non mais j'ai plus 5 ans, tu peux pas fouiller dans mes affaires.
Kathleen Carol Dunn. No next of kin. It might feel strange being back here, Kathleen. You could see it as a fresh start instead.
Tu veramente vuoi sparare a tuo padre? Lo sai che vuol dire ammazzare una persona?
Se li difendi, te devi difendere, alza le mani. Secco!
Hello? I'm offering one-way non-stop ticket to Greece. It will cost you 2,000 for an adult, 1,500 for a child.
Ivano, would you like to do the honors?
Oh, I'd like to open the thing. And the winner for Best International Feature, this is an incredibly moving and incredibly ambitious film for a debut film, is The Stranger's Case.
Oh yeah, sure. Take a moment. It's not my natural environment. I was a producer on the film. Brant Anderson is our director who couldn't attend, but firstly, thank you to Raindance. films like this are hard to make and very hard to get an audience for. You know, the refugee crisis is ongoing, and the state of the refugee, the way the refugees are treated with the British government currently is disgraceful. We felt, as a group of filmmakers, that it was very important to try and give faces to those people. And I would like to thank them. So this goes to the refugees. Okay, next up, please welcome Phil Hunt, Raindance's advisory board member and founder of Bankside Films.
Hello everyone, I'm not Phil, I'm David.
He couldn't be here with us today. But I am here to present the next category, which is the best performance in a debut feature. And the nominees are...
You know the drill, y'all know how it goes down. You need to find the duckies. You need to find the bucket with the duckies. On the count of three. 1, 2, 3, get it!
We need to define what we have built. Carve your adductus.
Why did you bring us here?
Your family belongs here.
That's a fucking weird way to put it.
Tu fouilles ma chambre maintenant.
Ne change pas de sujet, réponds à ma question.
Non mais j'ai plus 5 ans, tu peux pas fouiller dans mes affaires.
Kathleen Carol Dunn. No next of kin. It might feel strange being back here, Kathleen. You could see it as a fresh start instead.
Tu veramente vuoi sparare a tuo padre? Lo sai che vuol dire ammazzare una persona?
Se li difende. Se devi difende, alza le mani.
Secco!
No. I'm offering one-way non-stop ticket to Greece. It will cost you 2,000 for an adult, 1,500 for a child.
And the winner for best performance in a debut feature is... Paola Grimaldo for The Quiet Maid. Unfortunately, Paola, she couldn't be with us, but she sent us a very lovely video.
Gracias al Festival de Raydance por seleccionar a Calladita, por proyectarla y por disfrutarla. Estoy sumamente agradecida con el jurado que ha destacado mi interpretación y me ha otorgado este premio. Estoy muy feliz y ojalá pudiera estar allí personalmente, pero hace muy poquito he sido mamá y mi bebé me necesita. Quería darle las gracias también a Miguel Faust por siempre confiar en mí. Y darle las gracias al equipo Calladita por aportar su amor, su profesionalidad y siempre todo su empeño. Quería decirles que me siento súper orgullosa de formar parte de este proyecto y de haberle dado voz a tantas Anas del mundo que están pasando por situaciones muy difíciles y que necesitan un ápice de esperanza. Así que muchísimas gracias y un beso gigante.
Congratulations to Paola, and we'll make sure that she receives her award. Now, the next category, it goes for the best debut director in a debut feature, and the nominees are... There is no reel. We have the same reel. So the three categories that are coming up are the same nominees. So, the best director goes for, cool, Luke Guilford for National Anthem. So National Anthem is our closing film playing tomorrow 6:20 at Curzon Mayfair. The director is flying over Heathrow right now, so we will make sure to give this at the closing ceremony tomorrow. Thank you so much. Okay. And now we have the last award of the ceremony. And to present the Elisar Cabrera Discovery Award, I would like to welcome our founder, Elliot Grove, and Caroline Kennedy, Elisar's mother.
Elisar was another part of the wall that was Rain Dance, as I spoke of earlier. And this is his mom. Do you want to say something? I'll get all crazy. And his sister.
Thank you all for coming, and thank you, Elliot, for instigating this award along with Matt Devlin and Ian Powell and many others who helped support, and all the Rain Dance team, because many of you knew Elisar. He was a very special person, worked for Rain Dance right from the start. And I won't say much about him, except that if you are a young film director, you have to have three things: a heart full of passion, a head full of dreams, and an extremely indulgent single mother. And then you'll make it.
You want to say?
Shy. We have some tributes that were recorded by people that Elisar worked with, and also the early years of Rain Dance. So, Harvey.
I think about Elisar a lot. When we were growing up, we talked about making films so much, and when I got the opportunity, as I'm a little older than him, to actually start to make films, I brought him out to Los Angeles, and we worked together on a few films, and every moment that I spent with him was an absolute pleasure. His passion, his just his sense of fun in the process of making films was infectious, and think about those moments and that time a lot, and I miss Elisar a lot. And I'm so proud of the fact that this award has been named after him, because I know he'd be tickled. All he ever wanted to do was be part of the fabric of the film business, and this is another notch in his belt.
Hello, Adam Rifkin here, coming to you from Los Angeles. You know, I first met Elisar when we were both very young. I was directing a movie called The Invisible Maniac, and he was working on it. He then went on to work on a bunch of movies of mine, including The Dark Backward and The Chase, and we bonded over our mutual love of horror movies. So when I think of fake blood and rubber heads bouncing around, I think of Elisar, and it always makes me smile. A special shout out to Rain Dance and to Elliot Grove for recognizing Elisar in this wonderful way, and also congratulations to the winner of the very first Elisar Cabrera Discovery Award for debut feature. Well done. I love Elisar, I miss Elisar, and thank you for inviting me to be a part of this so that we can all be remembering Elisar together.
My dear friend Elisar Cabrera, I miss him so much. This is a wonderful honor, though, for a man that loved independent film. I think his first job might have been on The Dark Backward, a motion picture I produced, and he went from PA to MVP. What a wonderful honor, and I'm so glad we're celebrating Elisar. I miss him dearly. He was a fabulous young man, and he sure cared about film.
Hi, my name is Cary Elwes, and Elisar Cabrera was my cousin. For those of you who knew him, you know that Elisar was one of the kindest, most sincere, warm, and passionate individuals you ever had the chance to meet. You also know that his greatest passion was for movies. For Elisar, when the topic of films came up, you saw him light up. Besides forging his own career, Elisar was also very supportive in helping others achieve their dreams in this business. That was just the kind of selfless guy he was. And so I want to thank the Rain Dance Film Festival for recognizing Elisar's commitment to achieving excellence in this industry by creating the Elisar Cabrera Discovery Award for the Best Debut Feature. I cannot imagine a more fitting tribute to a wonderful creative man who would be truly humbled by this great honor, as his family are today in his absence. And with that in mind, we wish to offer our congratulations to the first recipient of this award in his name. Thank you.
Hey there, this is Edgar Wright, and I'm really honored to be talking about the Alizar Cabrera Discovery Award, because essentially Alizar discovered me. I was only 20 years old, 30 years ago this summer when I made my first film, A Fistful of Fingers, and Alizar was one of the producers on that. And he basically believed in me when I only had a couple of silly shorts and some amateur videos to my name. So I will forever be grateful for his belief in me. And I miss him very much, and I'm really excited that there is an award in his name. And my congratulations go to the winner of the first Alizar Cabrera Discovery Award.
My eyesight is better than my daughter's. Here are a few words from the jury members. Congratulations to Sleep, directed by Jason Yu, for winning the Discovery Award for Best Debut Feature. The jury found the film incredibly accomplished in balancing humor and fear in this engaging and effective horror debut. Despite its contained nature, in Sleep, the teenager builds from the outset with nuanced twist and ambiguous ending, carrying our doubt of whether Hu Xian is possessed or Su Jin has been driven to mental instability to the very end of the film. We were left with a tangible fear that lingered after the film's conclusion. The jury wishes the entire filmmaking team a sincere congratulations on this feature. And the winner is, as you have heard, is Sleep. I'm afraid no one is here to receive the award, so Elliot will receive it on his behalf. And I would like to introduce Cass Rawat from the International Arcade Chapter, who has raised money to finance this award every year for the Alizar Cabrera Discovery Award. So please welcome Cass Rawat.
I'm not one for big speeches, but with Raindance, independent film is very, very important. It means a lot to filmmakers when they're starting off. And I believe in the future we should all sponsor individual awards. So once again, thank you, Elliot. I'd like to present you this check on behalf of Sleep. I hope you all forward it on. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Got to keep the applause going. It's money up here. Come on, guys. Yeah, leave it with me. Yeah. Hey, so that's the award show, but there's more to the day. There's networking. There's a big panel on adaptations at 2 o'clock this afternoon. Between now and 2 o'clock, there's the alcohol at the bar. There's food around the town. And of course, tomorrow night, our closing night film and a party back here. Tell your friends about Raindance. We love you all. Have a great afternoon.